نظر
The pilgrimage to Mecca, known as the Hajj, is one of the five pillars of Islam. It's a journey that every Muslim is called upon to make. One of my earliest impressions of it is from the Bollywood classic Gulli. Amitabh Bachchan can't go to Mecca himself, so he pays for a poor man to go in his place. This is my mum. She was planning on going to the Hajj with my dad, but he died suddenly back in 1995. And now the only way she can go is with a male relative, which means me or my brother.
It's the obligation of every Muslim to perform the Hajj, and for my mum, it's been a bit of a lifetime's ambition. Unfortunately, when she was healthy, we never got round to going with her, and now she's 78 and a bit frail, and frankly, I don't think she could stand the trip to Mecca. So I'm taking her to the British Museum, which could end up being the next best thing.
Of course, my mum's no Islamic scholar. She's just an ordinary working-class Pakistani woman, typical of her generation. I'm not even sure she's ever been to a museum in her life. The Hajj is one of the great global gatherings of mankind, but it's something many non-Muslims know next to nothing about.
Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam.
So this is my wife, Bridget, and as you can tell, she's from a different background, so I'll be interested to see what she makes of the Hajj exhibition.
The Hajj is associated with the Prophet Muhammad from the 7th century, but the ritual of pilgrimage to Mecca is said to stretch back to the time of Abraham. The old British Museum reading room has been made over to help us feel we're on a pilgrimage ourselves. The Hajj now attracts nearly 3 million pilgrims every year from across the world. It involves a series of rituals which take place in and around Mecca over a period of 5 or 6 days. The first of these, and the most familiar image of all, is the Tawaf, in which pilgrims walk 7 times around the Kaaba, the black cube building, which is the most sacred site in Islam. The Hajj is a time when all Muslims, men and women, rich and poor, black, white and brown, can come to Mecca and for that moment at least are equal.
When you're there, you are just a Muslim, and there's sort of an equality
yes.
in that.
Yes.
And therefore, there's something about having a uniform of simplicity, because it's sort of there isn't a king or a pauper. So you're saying it doesn't matter whether you're rich or you're poor, you're all the same.
Same material, same style.
The exhibition charts the history and geography of the pilgrims' journeys. The perilous routes across the desert, in particular, caught the imagination of the West. This toy theatre set, the Caravan to Mecca, was made in Vienna in the early 19th century. In 1853, the explorer Richard Burton, who later translated the Arabian Nights, took part in the Hajj in disguise and brought back this flask of water from the holy Zamzam spring.
This guy learned Arabic and loved Islam, and so he had to hide it because he wasn't allowed.
I find this bit quite exciting, just thinking of what it must have been like to sort of be there and not know if you were going to be discovered, and to feel like you were one of the first non-Muslims to be experiencing this, and then to be able to then go out and tell the world about it. This whole exhibition made me think that I sort of do it quite individually, my spirituality, and people here, it's this huge river as the sort of metaphor that you keep feeling. It feels beautiful, the whole thing of everybody gathering together and joining as one.
While modern artworks explore the meaning of Hajj, this clip from the film Journey to Mecca explains its many and intricate rituals.
She just said that watching this here makes her feel like she's almost there.
For many pilgrims, this has been a profound spiritual journey that will have changed their lives forever.
A At the heart of the exhibition are the textiles traditionally hung on the Kaaba itself. They're decorated with lines from the Quran and other blessings. It's a rare opportunity to see them close.
So she's never seen this before because it's you have to actually have got near the Kaaba to have seen it, so this is all quite new for her.
As for souvenirs of the Hajj, none's more precious than the holy Zamzam water, said to originate from the time of Abraham and thought to possess near magical powers.
When my dad was in hospital after having a heart attack, I remember somebody came with, I think it was a metal kind of plate almost, like a saucer, which had some Zamzam water, and the idea was this was special holy water from Mecca, and it was there as a way of trying to offer some kind of solace and maybe some kind of medicine.
Does this make you want to go more? Like, kuch der baad jungi?
So I asked my mom if this made her eager to undertake the Hajj herself. She said that it's good to see these things here in the museum, but Mecca's really the place to see them.
I like.
She's saying that seeing this has made her want to go even more. Her heart's there, but it's really about Naseeb, which is the word for fate.